A very good afternoon to all of you. Thank you for being here with us. Thank you for taking out time for this webinar on this Sunday afternoon. So today we are going to have two very special guests who are also the founder of the sustainable brand called Kachchi Kali. So they are the artists who have turned into entrepreneur. So we are going to talk all about sustainability and how they are emerging as a brand who are calling them sustainability and how they are practicing all of it. So thank you for being here with us, and I am Proma Day. I'm going to be your host for the coming 30 minutes. Hope you will stay with us. Now let's go back to them.
So right now it's we are going to have a conversation because it's like September 2020 we are standing in the very crucial time where we are almost facing a paradigm shift where everything is going to change from one perspective to another, and we are hearing all those buzzwords like ethical fashion, sustainability, responsible fashion, and so many big words. So today we have with us the artist who finally turned themselves into entrepreneur, and right now they are the co-founders of the brand Kachchi Kali, which is a apparel and accessory brand. So welcome to this show, you guys. You guys are looking very like bright and vibrant already. So right now we are going to have this journey of how you coming up with this brand and how the journey started. So firstly, I would like to have a brief introduction of you guys, like let our audience know that who they are going to meet. So yeah.
So hello everyone. Thank you so much for having us with you. We are thrilled to be on the show with you. And so I'm Prakti Roy. I'm the founder of Kachchi Kali. So I am a NIFT graduate. I have done my graduation with fashion and lifestyle accessory design. And yeah, so my journey about design started from there. And
yeah, hello everyone. I'm Abhishek Anand. So I'm a co-founder of Kachchi Kali. And I'm also a NIFT graduate from NIFT Bangalore in fashion and lifestyle accessory design. So I'm also a designer too. And yeah.
Yes, so we know each other from college.
Come up with this idea that you want to open up this brand. Like, why it is Kachchi Kali? Like, the reason
behind it. Yeah, good question. So we passed out from college in the year 2018. So after so much of learning from such amazing faculty members and such an amazing institution, we had been thinking about, you know, using our design skills and giving back to the community that we live in. So yeah, that's how you know we started researching about, you know, Indian crafts and fashion industry, how it functions in our country, and that's how, you know, Kachchi Kali was born. And so if we actually focus on the name, if you break it down, it's Kachchi Kali, which is young bud. So our main focus was to, you know, kind of target the youth, people our age, you know, who are trying to understand this whole concept of sustainable fashion, and, you know, kind of target towards them. That was our main idea.
So Abhishek, I would like to know that how do you incorporate this sustainability approach in your brand or Kachchi Kali?
So talking about sustainability is, you know, is also to uplift the people who are, you know, from the, you know, on the grassroots level, and, you know, working to make all this Indian craft, you know, so, you know, vibrant and so, you know, cheerful and so sustainable to nature and, you know, sustainable to every, you know, market. So as a Kachchi Kali, we want to be, you know, more open to everyone. Like, it should be affordable. If we see sustainable, so it should be, you know, affordable at the same point. And
yeah,
we, you know,
we have that viewpoint that sustainable fashion has to be very expensive. So like, yeah. What do you think on that? Like, is it necessary for, like, sustainable fashion needs to be expensive?
I think no, it should not be. So, you know, if we talk about sustainability, it should be for many people, not for such certain group of people or certain society or certain community. So, yeah, I think it should not be, you know, that much, you know, priced.
So I would like to add on, you know, it has been set in our minds that when we look at Indian crafts or Indian sustainable products, the brands that we are aware of, it might not always fit the pocket of people like us. We're talking about the age group of 18 to 40 or 18 to 35. You know, it always comes across as, oh, it might be expensive. I'm interested in it, but I don't know how I'll be able to afford it on.
It's that, right? So I think this is also a barrier that why people are talking about sustainability, but they are not embracing it, but because maybe they can't afford it.
Yes, yes, correct.
So like which all craft sector you have worked with, or the artisans or the small scale sector that you are talking about? So
We are working with certain craft. We are also like new in this craft thing, and we are also exploring and we are also learning. So right now we are focusing like on the hand block printing from Rajasthan, and going to gamcha weaving from, you know, West Bengal. You know, we are also looking forward to, you know, introduce like ikat from Orissa, from, and we have also a range of kalamkari, which is from Andhra Pradesh. So we are, you know, targeting those people who are on, you know, as I said, are in the grassroots level, who are working, you know, to make this craft really, you know, encouraging and beautiful. So we are focusing on those type of thing, you know, directly we are focused. We don't want to be a third party or a second party. We just want to be with like vendors, artisans and us. That's it.
Okay. So it's like, why do you involve youth to with this brand? Like, why you kept youth in mind before opening up this brand?
Keeping youth.
What you do to make the craft likable for the youth?
When we just know the youth, when we talk about youth, we are so accustomed to all these, you know, westernized brands. When we talk about buying clothes, the first 2-3 brands that will come to your mind will be probably, you know, European or, you know, American brands. Our idea was, you know, to kind of study the global pattern, what is being liked by the people, the trends, and to adapt it into the craft and, you know, make it wearable for our market. So, you know, when we talk about craft, it should not be like, oh, it might not suit everybody. But our idea was to, you know, kind of mold it in a way so that, you know, even youth can find it trendy.
Okay. So you are targeting more to the youth and you are making the fashion affordable for them.
So, yes, 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 yes.
So, and how do you organize it? Like, we can like clearly understand that this is a slow fashion. We are not mass producing items. We are not taking multiple orders. So how do you customize or personalize? Like, how do you uplift the craft?
As we said, like, we are also learning this pattern, you know, whole craft industry right now. So what we do is that we directly go to the vendor, we source fabrics from them, and, you know, we are focusing, if we are sourcing fabric, we just go to the small vendors who are, you know, working from their home. So they don't have any, you know, they don't have any outlook about the world, how, you know, things are working. We are going directly to them so that we can uplift them. So when we source fabric from them, like block printing, ikat. So we go to the people who are, you know, like tailors. We are not going to any mass manufacturer or, you know, the people who are, you know, taking a bulk order to manufacture things. Mm-hmm. We are going to people who are working from their home. In this pandemic situation, we also know that, you know, a lot of people have lost their job. People are, you know, waiting for, you know, for money to earn. So we are going to these people, you know, especially women who are working from home, who are doing, you know, tailoring from their home. Mm-hmm. They are taking orders. So we are focusing those people, you know, those people, they have really good skills, you know, and this is, we want to create Kachikili as a platform where people can, you know, show their skills, whether it is a tailor, whether it is a, you know, weaver, or, you know, a person who is even doing a block printing. So we want to, you know, uplift them because they are the, you know, pillar of this thing.
Yeah. Actually, India is a place where we have such a variety, diverse craftsmanship. So I think as a designers, it's our responsibility to carry it forward. Maybe we have the makers, but we don't. They don't have the opportunity to, you know, showcase their products. So, like, how do you maintain the like transparency in your business? Because business is all about people, planet, profit. So, how do you take care and make a balance out of everything?
At the end of the day, it's a business, and we also need to we need to keep profit in mind. Mm-hmm. But for us, it has always been about, you know, connecting with the people, you know, connecting, supporting and empowering them. Mm-hmm. Them first, because if we can't do that, then we will not get the outcome that we're looking for, the finesse we're looking for. And craft is such a field where it's all about developing relationships with people first. Mm-hmm. And we need to understand that they love what they do. And we need to also, you know, kind of respect that. So we try to, you know, give them what they deserve in the process. Mm-hmm. So that's our aim, that, you know, we are
so
able
like
to give
they
them.
They should also like that what they are making. So they should also yes, feel definitely. Proud of them, what they are doing. So what are products you still like have, if you want to talk about your products right now, like what all you have?
So the story, it's a very small story. It started with accessories, actually. It started with earrings. Okay. I'm from Kolkata, so I was working in my city, and then I came across a lady who was making these earrings out of scratch cloth, which she had collected from the tailors. Okay. So I went to close to her, and then she told me, oh, I collect these cloth pieces and I make these earrings, and they were so beautiful. So and I was so fascinated. So and I walked with her over that vacation I was in Kolkata, and I developed some pieces, and that is how it started. And moving on, you know, I realized, why just accessories? Let's just you know, venture into clothes as well. Mm-hmm. So I'm a learner. I'm an accessory designer. So you know, apparel is something new to me, but I know what should feel comfortable when I wear it.
You should feel that connection of what you're wearing. And people also need to start understanding that clothes is not just we are wearing something, it's another skin. So we should respect that thing.
Yes, definitely. Yes, correct.
So what do you think about like Indian craft? What can be the future of it? Like, you are right now with it, and what do you feel about it?
So from the point of like Kachikali, not as an individual, I think we have to focus more on the youth. Like, we all know that India is a youth country, and you know, and we have a lot of, you know, craft in our country, and we and many of those we don't know that where they exist, but people, and also to make aware to the youth people, like how these craft, you know, can be a global icon for our country, or even to support the economy. Mm. So for an example, if we say I am from Bhagalpur. Mm. So there people make tassar silk and other linen fabric, and then there is one fabric called andi, which is very, you know, sustainable, which is like in winter it will make keep you warm, in summer it will keep you, you know, cool. So it is a kind of craft, you know, it is dying, because, you know, the generation, there is a generation gap. If a father is working with in this craft, the generation, and you know, their son, daughter, they don't want to be in this business, because they see it as a you know, a dying,
they are not
you
seeing
know
the prospect in it.
Yeah they are not seeing the future. So as a, you know, Kachikali, we can, you know, put all these things, you know, in youth mind, that, you know, these all things are also very important to, you know, to keep this craft, you know, alive. So if people will purchase, you know, then they will also get interest that, you know, we should continue this, you know, for further.
Exactly.
It's like I was going through one 2015 global report. So that was saying that in like globally, craftsmanship is the demand is around 400 billion. And in this scenario, India only offers 2% of it. So it's like India is the hub of all the craftsmanship, and we are just taking 2% of it. So it's like it shows a lot of potential. So it's like I'm really glad that you people came up and took this initiative and to make the craftsmanship to a next level. So how was your journey? Like, you have started in 2019 only. So how is the journey of your brand?
So I would say the journey has been exhilarating because when we are so passionate about something, we don't want to compromise in any way, right? We want it to be perfect. So it initially started with a lot of research, because what we have been taught in our whole curriculum of college, that you should always back whatever facts you have with research. So we did study a lot of other brands in the market who were doing similar things, and we picked up what we could learn from them and what we could change about certain things, so that has been a huge learning in itself. And of course, we have had a support system, like my parents have been so supportive in this, and his parents as well, so they have throughout pushed us, you do something. India needs to be on the global platform when it comes to craft.
That's it. And I think right now, after this pandemic has hit us, so it's a very different lifestyle that we all are leading in. So I think that our future can't sustain without sustainability in mind. It's like fashion will have no other outlook if it is not sustainable. So I think this is the time that we should all start, at least in a small scale, so that in future it can grow, more big. So I just saw that you have already put up some beautiful clothes in our Swipe In link section. So how are you getting the response? Like, when you are coming up, like, what kind of colors do you prefer? What kind of mood do you carry? So it's like, how do you describe, like, how it is fun and how it is?
So I would say we are all about colors, as you can see from that we have.
It's a very vibrant combination. Yeah,
very bright, vibrant. If you visit our Instagram page, you'll see all colors that are possible in the spectrum. But also, we try to cater to all kinds of likes and dislikes. We try to balance. If we are doing something very elegant and pastel and very soothing, we also try to have products that are bright, vibrant, and for the people who like quirky things. So it's a mix of both. Our design style is a mix of both. It's more contemporary. It's basically mix of craft with modern design.
Modern. So making it more appealing to the people and everyone.
Yes.
And so, also, like, keeping in mind that India is a colorful country, and we have a lot of colors in this, from Jammu and Kashmir to Kanyakumari, from Gujarat to Manipur.
So, so much color. I don't think any country can have in their palette. So I was also seeing that you have done some campaign. Would you like to talk about it? Like, some activities you did. So if you want to talk about
it. So it is that phase was very wonderful for us. We all know that we were in lockdown, and all people were sitting in at their houses, doing something. So we came up with this campaign, why not we can do something, uplifting, those, for example, I would like to say, like, our grandmother used to use those old saris to make those kathas, for a baby. So all those things are, I think, in home also, it is dying. If we are talking about sustainability, it should be upliftment of, we should do recycling also. It starts from home. So why not we can do something like a DIY challenge, where people can come up with some really good idea. And actually, we got few of them. Some people were using recycled sari, making it a crop top with that. Some people came up with lampshade with a gold tone clothes, and some people also made bangles all recycled things at home. So
ideas are all floating around. We just have to capture and keep going.
It's all about capturing.
Yeah, and also also to encourage people who are sitting at home, also they should also go back to their roots, talking to their grandmother, mother, how they did in their life, like how they did recycling.
I think this lockdown and social distancing, this all things has both pros and cons, because it's like we are not going out that often, but we are getting connected to our roots. It's like we are sitting and we are trying to get some hobbies. So we are starting with embroideries. Like, people used to say that we don't have time for that, but now this is it's a holistic approach that people are going for craft, they are making paintings. So all these things are becoming more and more. So do you do experiments with the designs of it to make it more modern, but keep the technique same so that it becomes more to the time?
Yes, so we do. So inspiration can come from anywhere. So let's give you an example. So recently I had been very inspired by Jamini Roy paintings, you know. Yeah. Okay. So it's very popular from where I come from. So, you know, I got really inspired by it and I, you know, kind of molded it to make it, you know, turn it into earrings. Yeah. We made a Frida Kahlo in the style of Jamini Roy. Jamini Roy's time. So we don't know where the inspiration comes from. It can come from anything around you. And you
so
just
do you do customized, personalized product if someone else asks you to?
Yes, in accessories, yes. Clothing would be a little difficult, but accessories, yeah, because some of them, I have a team who paints with me and I also paint the earrings. It's hand painted. Yeah. So, we do customizations as per your liking.
And how is the response that you're getting? How is the feedback? Like, how people are responding to what you are doing?
Feedback is really good. Like, you know, people also come up with the suggestions how we can, you know, improve our, you know, quality. Mm-hmm. How we can, you know, make it more, you know, how we can use more sustainably, more sustainable products and more eco-friendly products. So people are really enjoying our, you know, initiative, and they are also, you know, encouraging us to, you know, how we can take it forward.
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's like sustainability is a very big buzzword that we all are hearing. So now it has got different approach to it. So what is your take on sustainability and how do you think that you can apply it in your brand or in your life?
So, sustainability as a whole is about the entire process of the product being made till it reaches the consumer. But we also have to keep in mind that when we talk about the product's process, like the production of the product, the craft itself should be sustainable, right? As you mentioned, as the generations who have been involved in this craft, they should also feel inspired to continue it. Because, I am a designer, but the skill sets that they have, it's unmatched for. I mean, what they know, I will never be able to know. It comes with a lot of experience. Yeah. So for us, it has been, you know, to target this a small group of people who are, you know, trying hard to sustain their craft first. And, you know, then apply the products which will have sustainable features. Yeah. But, sustainable.
So we have to first preserve the makers who are actually the passion, because otherwise this all will become history. Because if we don't have someone who will carry forward the tradition, then we are going to, and we are facing a future where all this craftsmanship will become the thing. So I think this is why we have to, you know, like make all those things greater. So like, how do you think that the coming future is going to look like? Like, what do you think? Fast fashion, slow fashion, like people will go for more customization or they are going for price? Like, what do you think what is your view for the future?
So our view for the future is, you know, I think people will go for a customization, I think, in future. Because, you know, lifestyle is changing, you know, we are, you know, getting to the, in urban lifestyle, I think people want to, you know, explore more about themselves more, you know, how they are looking, how they are, you know, how, what
the
personality.
Identity. Maybe.
Yeah, the identity. So, and also to focus more on youth, we have to, you know, educate this youth people, like, you know, we have to, you know, we can do many things with our crafts, you know, if you want to create your personality, we have all those things in this country. And that is how, you know, like, you know, doing some campaign like we did DIY thing, and it can be, you know, more, you know, in a larger scale.
So like, we have to generate the appreciation first, and then only we can think about a market in future.
Yes.
But it is, I think, certainly promising that it is going to be the thing.
Let's hope so. Let's hope so.
So any new designs in mind? Anything is brewing that we are going to see soon?
Yeah, lots brewing actually. So we are trying to keep up with the times, and we are working on new designs, you know. The whole mask thing has been trending, you know, the whole different designs in masks. And so we are trying to work on some new designs, keeping up with the times. You will be getting to see them soon. It takes time because, you know, the situation has been so hard on us the past few months. Mm-hmm. But let's hope it gets better and we can, you know, give the best to you guys.
Yeah, I think like brands are coming in, obviously, because people are slowly changing. So I think it's a huge part on the consumers because they have to first make the decision or make the choice of buying the product. So I would say, like, to all the audience that sustainability is the next big thing that we can't really escape. We have to embrace it and it will be good as soon as we do it. So the first thing is we have to be very careful about the choices we make because every small choices make a difference to the world. And we should be living for a world and we should make it like people, planet and profit. But we should never keep the, we should always keep people before profit so that there is a holistic approach towards the thing. So finally, would you like to say something towards our audience, like the beautiful audience who listen to all our conversation? So anything for them?
Thank you so much for being with us, firstly. And this has been such a great experience talking about. When I just sat today, I realized that, you know, I have actually learned so much over this time. When I talk to you, it all comes back as a flashback. Oh, I have learned so much, and you know, it's been such a great experience. Mm-hmm. And to everyone who's viewing, I mean, yeah, as you said, like, be conscious of the clothes you wear, because be conscious about the life cycle of the product that you're using. Know where it goes after you're done wearing it or after you discard it. So that's so important. You know, if it ends up in a landfill or where it goes, just be aware of those things. So that will make a difference. You know, you as an individual can make a difference.
So there was, I would like to add one thing. There was one hashtag that was going on in Instagram that who is behind our clothes? Like, we are forgetting that whatever is wearing is, there is people behind. So who make my clothes? So we have to have that relation with the garment, with the person who has made it, because he has put his effort into making this beautiful outfit. And I think craft is the best way of expression, because all the little embroideries, the prints, the intricacy, detailing, this all is about the person behind. So when we wear a clothes, we should also respect our clothes. So I think that is what will be the first change in our mind, that what we wear, we should respect. So then only the entire thing can change. So,
of course.
So we also had one, you would like to say about the hamper?
We did this small thing where we shared a swipe link with you guys. It's a nice surprise. So we'll pick a lucky winner out of it and we'll give us like customized Kachikali hamper to you. And I'll make sure I curate the best out of our collection and it will be given to you.
So yeah, so that link is available on all the social platforms. So those of you who haven't done it yet, I would ask you to please go and check their products. It's really beautiful, amazing. Like in this lockdown and social distancing, those vibrant colors are really attracting me. Like, I would also love to wear one of them. And also, if you have any questions or if you want to give us a feedback towards this live session, and this is the first time that we are coming up together, like Kachikali and Be Spoken, and having this talk at Sunday afternoon. So we are very glad for giving us the time and being with us. So any feedback or anything that you would like to share, do reach us to the to our online portals. And thank you, Prapti and Abhishek. It was very nice being with you and having the conversation. So hope to see more products and more beautiful thing in the future.
Thanks to each one of you. Thanks to each one of you for being here. We are glad.